Hi, everybody. I'm Chief Meteorologist Jay Cardosi with an updated video weather blog for you as we kick off this new work week. The good news, after that very, very wet period, last 3 to 4 days, all the rainfall, this system is finally getting a kickoff towards the east and northeast. But now, of course, on this Monday late afternoon, we have the colder air driving into the region. And on the backside of this light precip, we've had reports of a little bit of light snow and also some sleet from time to time. That trend will continue through the early evening hours on Monday. Then everything will get on out of here. And no, we're not expecting any accumulations and no problems expected on the roadways either. Again, the big weather story are the northwesterly winds blowing in that colder weather. Look at some of these temperatures. Readings have really dropped off the table from this past weekend when we were well into the 60s on Sunday afternoon. Now in the 30s, even some 20s showing up off to the northwest. And that colder air will continue to push in to our region for the next several days. Let's jump ahead now. We're going to look at the next 10 days and see if we can see any chances for snow around the region. Here is Thursday later this week. High pressure setting up. Now here's the map of the United States. This is the surface pattern, and that's big area of high pressure really across the eastern one half of the lower 48. Louisville about right there at the tip of my finger, and the high pressure system is going to dominate the rest of this week. So once we get rid of this light precipitation on this Monday late afternoon, early evening, it looks to be dry and quiet for the remainder of the work week. And actually temperatures will start to moderate Thursday and also into Friday. For Saturday, the new weekend, we're watching yet another system coming out of the plains, but this one too is going to take a northern route, which simply means it will bring us just some rain. And it does not to be nearly as strong as this last system. So a quick mover with rain likely to form sometime late Saturday into Saturday night and also into Sunday. Things quiet down for Monday, but by next Tuesday, as a very active weather pattern develops on us, December 18th, here comes yet another system a little bit farther off to the south. But again, this one, as it moves off to the northeast, will not have much cold air to work with in the Ohio Valley. So mainly a rain event, maybe even a few thunderstorms trying to mix in. But there are chances for some significant snow a week from tomorrow, December 18th on Tuesday, from the Central Plains through the Upper Midwest and also the Great Lakes region. On the backside of the system, it's possible that we could pick up a flurry or two by Wednesday morning, but no big deal. Now, things do get a little bit more interesting on December 20th or next Thursday, a week from this Thursday, if you will. This is the upper atmospheric pattern, about 18,000 feet in the atmosphere, the 500 millibar pattern. And check out this big closed low pressure system over the northeastern United States. That's going to act like a big block in the atmosphere. So the bottom line, any other systems that come in from the western U.S. towards the Ohio Valley will be forced to take the southern route. And this is what we look for this time of the year if you want wintry weather across the Ohio Valley. So things are shaping up a week from this Thursday to be a little bit more active wintry weather-wise. Now, the big question is, will there be enough cold air to generate snow in our area with that system on December 20th? It's a close call right now. It is marginal. You can see that narrow black line that's kind of arcing across Tennessee and Kentucky state line just south of Louisville. Typically, that's very close to the rain-snow line. So at this point in time, yeah, there could be enough cold air to generate some snow, especially as you approach the Ohio River and points off to the north. It's something we'll be updating, but just know, until that time, until December 20th, it looks very quiet winter weather-wise. But by the time we move into, let's say, next Thursday, possibly Friday, we could be looking at some wintry weather right here in the Ohio Valley. It's something we'll be updating you on. And again, thanks very much for watching the video weather blog right here at WLKY.com.